Hi and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're talking about the 10 most used phrasal verbs in English. If you want to know about that, stay with me. So what's a phrasal verb? It's a verb with two parts, normally an adverb or a preposition coming together with a verb. And when that happens, the meaning of the verb changes. Let's take a look in the first example. Give. Give is when you give something. It's yours and you give to other people. But when you put together give and up, give up, the meaning is totally different. Give up means stop doing something. It could be positive or negative. For example, I gave up smoking 4 years ago. I gave up smoking 4 years ago. Number two, move out means to leave a place of residence or work. She moved out last summer. She moved out last summer. And you can use also move in, to move to a new place. For example, she moved in last summer. She moved in last summer. Third, hold on means to wait, to wait. I had to hold on for 2 long hours. I had to hold on for 2 long hours. Number four, look something up means to search something in a book or in a computer. I looked the file up for the entire morning. I looked the file up for the entire morning. Check out, we use that in Portuguese, means to pay the bill and leave that place. A hotel or a restaurant. I had already checked it out when I remember we were out of water. I had already checked it out when I remember we were out of water. Come up with something means to bring a new idea out of nowhere. I need to come up with a great idea to make money. I need to come up with a great idea to make money. Wake up means when you are sleeping and you get off your bed, or it could be a call also. Wake up, pay attention. She always wakes up late. She always wakes up late. Workout means to exercise, to do some physical activity, or when someone gets good results of an action, for example. We expect everything works out for you. We expect everything works out for you. The next one is go over. Means to check or to examine something. For example, my boss persists to go over my work every day. My boss persists to go over my work every day. And the last one is make something up. Means to tell a story that is not so true or to tell a lie. My son enjoys making up tall tales. My son enjoys making up tall tales. If you learned something new, please leave in the comments a phrase with that new verb. If you like the content, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. We have new videos every week about English. And remember, you will learn English. It depends only on you. See you!